And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's the event you've all been waiting for.
Everybody, Stephen Brody Stevens here. Welcome to a fresh episode of Brode and Esther here on the Death Squad Podcast Network. Let's go ahead and get right into our intros.
I can't believe we're here. We made it.
We're back.
So soon, you know, I saw the messages from people, when's the next episode? And I said, hey, Brian and Brody, let's do it tonight.
Yeah, you took action.
Thank you.
You're always the one that takes action, it seems.
I am. I'm into action.
You got the ball rolling.
Yeah.
You sent out a 3-person email, text.
Text, which I'm very fond of.
Some people don't like it, though, just so you know.
Whoa.
Group text?
A lot of people don't like it, actually.
Why not?
Because when you do a group text, it shows everybody's phone number. So, like, if you do a group text with, like, 5 people and 2 of those people aren't friends and they hate each other, or, you know, like, one's, like, a celebrity or something weird like that, they can see everyone's phone numbers.
Well, that's why you have to have a group text technique. It has to be a pre-discussed group text. You know, you have to know that all those people are friends. You can't just send out randoms, because I've gotten randoms, and I once accidentally sent something to the group when I thought it was just an individual. And I embarrassed myself.
What did you do?
I said, does anyone want... It was actually during the last episode of this podcast, and I was asking you guys to get food or have caramel apples. And so I sent a text to my friend that said, do you want to go eat bad stuff with me and caramel apples? And I sent it to 6 people I didn't know.
Did they show up?
No, I got no takers.
No takers?
None.
Did you go on your own?
No, I didn't. It would have been too weird.
Caramel apples? Where do you get those at?
Get what?
Caramel apples. Caramelized apples?
That's like, what is that, Family Guy? When Brian says, or when the little baby says something weird?
It's also when my dad says Volkswagen.
Volkswagen? Oh, that's full on German.
Yeah.
That makes me take a step back as a blue-collar Jewish guy.
Well, he is a blue-collar Jew. He just doesn't know how to say stuff.
Oh, your father's Jewish. Your mother's not.
Right. So you could get... Wait, what were you asking me about?
I was asking you about apples.
What kind specifically?
Caramel? Caramel? Is it caramel?
You tell me.
I think it's caramel. Caramel.
What apples. Were you saying before?
Caramel what? Apples? Caramel apples.
It sounds like a hospital.
Well, Carmel is the name of a town in California that Clint Eastwood used to be the mayor of.
Very good, Esther. A lot
Thank
of people
you.
Don't know that.
Thank
or,
you.
You know, people in your age bracket
Thank
aren't
you.
Aware of that.
Thank you, Brody.
And I'm proud that you were proactive with that knowledge.
Yes. When I drove up the coast of California with my mom and my dad spit out that information at me, I was proactive about listening.
You remembered?
Yes.
Did you get good grades in high school?
They were pretty good. I didn't try too hard.
Really? Were you a good test taker?
No, I excelled in the arts. I was also in the gifted program in elementary school, and then one day I was like, I don't want to do this. I want to be with my friends. Do I have to do this? And the teacher was like, no, this is extra. And I was like, oh, okay, bye. And then I quit.
So was it too hard for you?
No.
I mean, too easy?
No, it was just boring. Like, I'm inherently lazy, so when I found out that I was doing work I didn't have to be doing, I
right.
just quit.
Like extra credit?
Yeah, sort of.
Sort of.
I probably would be like a scientist now if I wasn't so lazy.
Why do
but
you
not really.
My, this is a technical question.
A what?
Technical?
this Wait. Is a technical question. If my headphones are too loud, what should I do, Brian?
Same. Mine just got louder.
Should I turn them down?
Let me see.
Two. Check. Two.
Technique.
Technique. How about this? Right there. Is that better?
Yeah. No. 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 Yeah.
No,
that's better.
No. Yeah. No. No.
No.
No.
No.
Yeah.
No.
No.
No. Yeah. No. No.
Now they're all off.
Yes.
Two.
Yes. Yes.
Two. Two.
Yes.
I think a little more for
Stay.
Me.
Stay.
Two. Check. Check. Two. Stephen Brody Stevens.
Technique.
Technique. Right there.
Carmel.
Do you remember Technique, the company that made cheap stereos?
Technics.
Oh.
Was it Technics or Techniques?
I always thought it was Techniques.
You can find those shirts at Urban Outfitters.
I'm a touch too loud. No, I'm fine.
You're good. This is perfect.
So where do you get Carmel apples?
If I was to get one, do they sell them at Canner's Delis?
Where?
Canner's Delis. What's wrong? What'd I say wrong?
What?
It's not plural. It's singular. Canner Delis. I know I'm saying it wrong. Canter's Delis. Canter's Deli. The deli.
Who's meowing?
The clock.
Oh.
The cat clock.
I'd love to have a lot of cats.
So, Esther, are you upset that I'm moving officially now?
Yeah. I mean, also, why drag it out, you know? I thought you were gone, and then I see you're still there. So I'm like, oh, is he staying? But it's, you know, it's like a bad breakup.
Well, I paid for rent, so I have still the whole month. I can take the whole month to move out, but I'm not going to officially sleep over my new place until I have a bed in there.
Have you moved anything over at all?
Yes, I have.
What have you, like big stuff or just like a couple boxes?
Just a few Rubbermaid boxes that I brought up and took them over. I'm going to bring some more boxes tonight, and then I'm going to bring some clothes, and then Benji, a Flawlo, our good friend, is going to have a truck, and I'm going to move some furniture tomorrow.
Brody, I'm worried that you're saving not having a bed as a crutch.
Meaning
I think
what?
I'm afraid that you'll never get a bed because it's your crutch not having one.
I'm going to get a bed. I've gotten a bed before.
I don't believe you.
I bought a bed no problem
I think you
5 years ago.
I think you have bedophobia.
I don't have bedophobia.
Team, come on out.
But I'll tell you what.
We have a team of bedophobia specialists.
Is this an intervention?
Bedvention. Is it because you don't like an empty bed, like when you go home and it's just empty? Or
who comes home to a full bed?
I'm going to get a bed. I already got the apartment. What do you think is harder, getting an apartment or getting a bed?
Probably getting an apartment for most people, but for you, getting a bed is the hardest thing in the world.
Well, I got a bed no problem 5 years ago.
And you're holding on to that. You can't let go of the past.
Well, I left that bed at my old apartment, and then I got the air mattress, which has been very comfortable.
Here's the question on everyone's mind. Where's the old bed?
I left it in my old apartment.
So you abandoned your old bed. So now do you have guilt, and that's why you don't want to get a new bed, because you feel like your old bed is missing you?
There is some... I wonder where that bed is now. Is somebody sleeping in that bed? I drive by my apartment, the old one, and I look in there, and I wonder, is my bed in there? Is my futon couch in there?
I knew it.
Is my refrigerator? I left the refrigerator there. I left the sofa futon couch there, and I left my bed there.
Did you get charged for that?
Why would I be charged?
Because you just left your bed there. You're supposed to clean your apartment out before you leave it.
Well, they said I could leave it. I offered to leave it at their...
So they could rent it out like a furnished apartment?
That or take it themselves because the bed was good. I couldn't carry that stuff and put it into storage. I had to go from store... I didn't go from apartment to apartment. I went from apartment to storage to an apartment. And I just felt that the bed... and the refrigerator and the futon sofa couch in the frame is just too much.
Does the bed have any pee stains on it?
No, the bed does not have any pee stains. I didn't wet my bed. I haven't done that for 8 years, maybe.
When you did wet your bed, how did it happen? Did you wake up and go like, I'm peeing, or did you, was that a night of drinking, or what did you do?
I think I just dreamt about it. If you dream that you're peeing, chances are you're peeing.
Were you upset at yourself? I mean, did you make it a bit at the time, or did you?
I mean, I was a little ashamed. I'm trying to think when I last peed my bed. And to be honest with you, it wasn't all that long ago for the last time that I urinated in my sleep in my bed.
I'll throw this out there. I pooped my pants recently.
You did?
Were you sick? Oh, yeah.
Senior year of high school.
Oh, they're going to say like this week.
No, not that recently.
Oh, I've done that. I do that like 3 times a year now.
But yeah, you like fart and it little pops out and you're like, oh, there's a little poop in there.
No, not like that. And we like to keep it clean.
What?
Well,
your underwear clean?
Literally.
I will usually have it be when I'm coming back from a coffee house, like whether I'm at Coffee Bean or Starbucks and I'm in the middle of going home.
Uh-huh.
You know, a couple times walking home from Starbucks at my old apartment, I didn't make it across that final street, if you know what I'm saying. And then...
Why not? Is it that you have to poop and then you're just, you're scared to do it in the public place?
No, I'll do it in a public place, and I did it in a public place today, actually. The Starbucks, I kind of not... I mean, the line could be long sometimes for the restroom. And I was walking home. It just caught up on me. I don't have a problem... having a...
Is your butt stretched out for any 10% reasons?
Have you considered adult diapers? Wait, what do you mean 10%?
Let's keep it clean. The 10% gay. I'm 10%...
Oh, you're not. We discovered that you're not. But have you considered adult diapers?
No.
No. Brian, have you?
Yeah. I mean, I just put a little toilet paper in there when I know I'm like a little leaky that day. Because sometimes you're a little leaky. Like you'll have like a... like that, and you're like, whoa, that felt a little slimier than normal or a little weird. And you put your hand in there and you're like, all right, this is socks, you know, and you have to like hide your hand from your friends until you can find a bathroom. So like days like that, I'll put like a little man tampon thing action just in there, you know, just for protection. So that won't happen again until I can make it home and,
you know,
shower.
For women.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, that was really terrible. But for women who pee a lot, why not adult diapers?
Well, I'll tell you.
It's really drastic. I don't.
As
think,
long as they know. Make them for teens, because I have a small
adult
body.
Diapers are for older people, generally speaking.
Generally speaking, but why?
Over 40.
Why do they have to be?
Like, that's what they're, it says on the, you know, the packaging, isn't it? Like over 40?
Over 40? Yeah. I'm over 40.
Have you talked to your doctor?
Well, you say you poop yourself a lot, so maybe.
No, I don't. And the only reason I was because I was having coffee. And walking home.
Does coffee make it? Is that what that does?
Coffee, you know, gets you going, gets you regular. You've heard that before. You must have.
No.
You heard about Clint
does.
Eastwood.
Being
the mayor of Carmel.
I take two sips of my coffee and immediately it's like, oh, got to go poop now.
Well, I don't
do
know.
Do you do it at home or do it there at the...
I walk home from Starbucks. Like I never stay at Starbucks. I just get it and go.
But I had it recently. One time I did, it was like a bran muffin in my pants.
Do you think in caveman days they were caveman diapers type things?
Or no, they
do
probably
you think they pooped in rivers.
I don't even think they were. I think they just pooped while they walked. But, you know, like I think they didn't even care. Like it was,
they probably used leaves to wipe.
Yeah.
I'll be honest today. I did use the restroom at Coffee Bean. I'll have to do it. I mean. I just go in quick, and if you got to go, you got to go, and you feel so much better after you do that. And I know we're talking
after
about...
After you go in the bathroom and...
Yeah, because I want to stay at Coffee Bean. I don't want to have to go home. You know, some people actually go home to use their own toilet, but I was, like, enjoying my time at Coffee Bean. I had a good parking spot.
They call it away games.
What do you mean?
If you poop not at home, it's called an away game.
I haven't heard of that before.
I heard it once. I didn't make it up.
You didn't make it up?
No, I don't think I did.
So, Esther, tonight you're wearing your pajamas?
These aren't pajamas necessarily. This is just a onesie.
And were you out in public tonight with that?
Yes, I was. Yes, sir.
Where did you go?
Here.
Did you just go from your apartment door to your car in here, or did you go out in a public setting?
No, but I will afterwards.
Where are you going to go dressed like that?
To a comedy club.
What? Are you really?
Yeah.
What comedy club?
The Store.
Comedy Store?
Yeah.
You're going to dress like that tonight there?
Yeah, it's my outfit tonight.
You're going to make a splash.
I'm pretty excited because Carlos bought me some boner pills today, and I can't wait to try them out. Sometime.
Carlos Herrera?
Yeah.
What do you mean he bought you boner pills?
He has these boner pills called Hot Rod 5000.
Yeah.
And Teeb took them, and he said it was just amazing. It was just like nonstop boners, and he had like he could come like 50 times in a row, and it was great.
How does Carlos have these? He didn't tell me about this.
Carlos has boner pills?
Yeah. He doesn't tell me and Brody this stuff.
Well, you know, me and Carlos have this special relationship where we talk about boners all the time with each other.
Oh, that sounds really special.
But, no, so I wanted to borrow one, and then I said, like, hey, I'll pay for it. But I was like, actually, if you're ever near that store, just grab me some. And
what
I'll,
store?
I don't know. It's some store.
Pleasure Chest?
No, it's like...
On Santa Monica
this
and
sounds
WeHo?
Like it's like a hooker store.
No, yeah, I don't know what it is. It's someplace in Santa Monica. I think it's like a vitamin store type place.
Well,
because it's
these...
all natural. It's all natural.
Oh, it is.
Yeah. And it's like extracted from ants or something weird
what?
Like that. And I want to try it out. I've never done it. I don't need them, but I've always wanted to try one that where you're just like, you can't get enough boner type shit. Have you ever taken a boner pill before, Brody?
No, but I've taken nitric oxide, which is a workout pill, which opens up your veins, arms, gets the blood flowing, and indirectly it affects blood flow to your penis, too.
So you just rock hard when you're working out?
You can be. I mean, it gives it blood flow. It opens up your arteries and your veins, and so a lot of people work out with it. And that is one supplement I'm going to get back into is nitric oxide, because I want to get back to the old Brody, and that was taking supplements, getting blood flow, lifting weights, getting endorphins. You know, today I hiked.
Here, take this before your next hike.
What is that, boner pills?
No, it's on it.
Right? Shroom technology?
Yeah, it gives you a stronger, longer workout. It's got cordyceps mushrooms in it, and it's just... Like, I would say you probably get, if you take these, you'd probably get like a 15% more workout, 20% more energy. It's great, you know, for right before you work out.
How does it hit you right when you work out, though?
No, I think you take it, I think it says on here you take it like 30 minutes before or something like that.
How are these different, say, from amino acids or glutamine?
I have a feeling
or
Brian
protein.
Doesn't know the answer to that question.
Well, I don't actually don't take these.
But he's going to take a good shot at making it up.
I don't take these, but...
Why not? Because you don't work out.
I don't work out.
Shroom tech.
They won't do anything. But on it now sponsors us at Desk Squad. So if you want to buy these yourself or get more information, just go to onit.com and use coupon code Desk Squad and save yourself 10%.
They send you this stuff?
Yep.
I will sponsor. I will talk about it when I try it.
Yeah. What are you trying?
I'm going to try.
You got two bottles.
Alpha Brain and Shroom Tech. I would try New Mood. I'll try anything and then I will review it.
What does Alpha Brain supposedly do?
It's like a natural, the easy way to explain, it's almost like a natural Adderall. It gets your, your brain juices working. It's supposed to clear your head.
Whose titties are these?
Those aren't real titties.
Oh.
That's the iPad mini that I've been fucking around with since Friday. Haven't charged it once.
Are you serious?
Haven't charged it once since Friday, and I've streamed on it for, I think, 3 hours today, 2 hours today, and 3 hours the other day. I've been using it nonstop, and there's still, what, 7% battery
it's
on?
It's at 8%.
8%.
What do you like better about the mini as opposed to the regular iPad?
The regular iPad's nice. It's great. But, I mean, it's also fucking huge. You know, it's like, who wants to take, you know, this and walk around with it, you know?
It's like a notebook, though.
Yeah, but it's also, I mean, if you don't want to carry this around. This is, like, heavy and big. This, the iPad mini's small.
Right.
So it actually fits in my pocket, in my jeans. And another thing, though, is typing, like, on this, like... It's just kind of big. Your hands are stretched in the middle.
I agree.
With the mini, it's like perfect. It's just like it's bigger than an iPhone, but it's great for notes. Like this weekend, I was in Seattle and San Francisco with Rogan, And I was using it to write new jokes on and shit like that. And it feels good in the hand. It's like the perfect size for games. Like games on your iPhone, a little too small, a little hard to control. iPad, they're pretty nice. This is just like a good balance of like just the perfect size for like Netflix. It's, you know, it's big enough. It's, you know, iPhone, Netflix is kind of weird. Games are better. It's like a better size.
Right.
So it's like an iPad, but it's smaller, where you would actually probably carry it around more, have it in your pants pockets more. It's light. I really didn't think I was going to like it as much as I did, but ever since I've had it, I just nonstop using it.
Is this going to be a hit for them?
I think it is.
It seems like it started out to be
It
a
doesn't
hit.
Seem like it's going to start. It started off as a hit at all, especially since when I was in San Francisco. And launch day, and it was like 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I'm like, oh, there's an Apple store a mile away. I'm gonna walk over there. And I didn't think they were gonna have any in stock.
You walked 1 mile?
Yeah. That's what you do in San Francisco.
Oh, right.
And so I walked there, and I was like thinking they're not gonna have any in stock. They had them all in stock, which was weird. You know, they launched at 8 a.m. that morning. So
yeah.
I thought they would be sold out completely. They weren't sold out of any of them. So, yeah, I think this is one of those slow ones where people are going to start playing with it and then realizing, oh shit, this is nicer than having an iPad. I would actually use this more.
I'll say this. When I first saw that they came out with an iPad mini, I was like, are you kidding? That's so useless. This is their planned obsolescence bullshit of making new stuff. And it's kind of unfair, and I still am against it. However, I am playing with it and I do kind of like it.
It's nice. It feels good in your hand.
That's because I'm a mini person.
Yeah.
Are there different sizes in terms of memory or gigabytes or storage?
Yeah, I believe it's 16, 32, 64. So there's 16 gig, 32 gig, and 64 gig.
And can you get a data plan with that? Do you need to sign up a Verizon or anything?
Well,
like
that one that she's using is just the Wi-Fi version. The data ones come out earlier or later this month, where it's going to be Verizon or AT&T. I believe it's like $15 a month. The reason why I didn't go with it is because 90% of the time you're around a Wi-Fi network. You know, you're here at the studio, you're home, you're at a Starbucks. Most of the time you're going to have a Wi-Fi network. When you don't have a Wi-Fi network, if you have an iPhone, you have the ability to stream to hotspot.
Right.
So I just do that. So like,
doesn't your iPhone have to be jailbroken to do that?
No. They offer that now as a part of the new operating system, iOS 6. Being able to create a hotspot on your phone. So what it does is you pretty much just turn it on, and it broadcasts internet into the room that you're in. And so then you could have a password so no one else can get on it.
Wait, you can do that now?
Yeah, on your iPhone.
How?
I can show you later. It's in general settings, hotspot.
I got to do the update on the iPhone.
You haven't done it?
No, am I supposed to?
Yeah.
Brody.
Why?
You're holding on to the past. You want your old bed back.
Yes, I do. But I'm going to get a new bed. Wait, how important is it for me to update the new iPhone?
It's not important. I mean, you actually will lose a superior map program on there. The maps are better on the old operating system
because
it's the old Google Maps. But it's, I don't know. It's just that there's probably a lot of, I think there's a lot of cool new features with the new operating system that you might like.
How long will it take for me to download or upload it?
I don't know. 30 minutes?
That's all?
Yeah.
I'll do it tonight.
Yeah.
Just plug it in there and let it sink.
Yep.
Will I lose any of my... my
just back up before you sync. You know how? Just when you plug it in your iTunes, just hit the backup button.
Uh-huh.
And then do it. So if something goes wrong, you have a backup of it.
I need help with my computers. Are there people who come to your house that know Macintosh and set up
Geek
everything?
Squad.
Yeah, you could pay for like Geek Squad, or you can just find, you know, like a comic that is younger. Most younger kids know how to do everything nowadays.
They do?
Yeah.
I'm a younger kid.
Yeah, but you're an old lady inside.
Esther, are you pretty technically set? Yes, you are.
Thanks, Brody. I am an old lady inside, unfortunately. But
you have an old soul.
Yeah, I have an old...
I mean, even your top button of your hoodie, your pajamas is buttoned.
Well, yeah, isn't it supposed to?
No. You gotta let some air in there.
Yes, I have older tendencies. I like to read in bed. I like to lay in bed. I like to sleep in bed while others party. and do other things that they. I'm not into parties.
I never really realized that, Brody. She looks like she's super young, but she acts like she's super old.
Esther. You know what? She's probably better off in the long run that way.
Yeah.
To be more mature. You might feel like, do you feel like you're missing out on anything by not
Sometimes,
going to these parties?
Yeah.
Do you want to go to the parties?
No, I don't. But what? Sometimes I feel like, well, because in college, everybody had fun except for me. So I feel like I probably missed out on something.
What is fun for you these days?
These days, fun stuff for me is...
Podcasting. Performing. Okay.
Feeling really tired and getting in bed.
That's a good feeling.
I like snacks.
Snacks are delicious.
Yes. What about you? What else? What am I missing?
Like, do you feel like you're missing out? Like, you're not going to parties.
You're not getting plowed as much by strangers.
Oh, my God. Brian, that is completely uncalled for.
What does that mean?
You know, like, you meet somebody at a party, and they're like, hey, why don't you go to the bathroom? And then you pull down your little pajamas, and they fuck you in the bathroom.
Brian, we have to keep it clean. That is, I mean.
That's not a thing that people do.
Yeah, that's what happens at parties.
No, when you're saying I lay in bed and sleep, I eat snacks, the next thing that comes to mind isn't pulling your pants down and having sex with a stranger. Usually.
You took it to another level, Brian.
Yeah, Brian.
And that's not the flavor of the show. We are positive energy.
Yeah.
I am a fatherly figure, an older brother, if you will, for Esther.
We're a mild flavor. You're being spicy. Too hot. Too hot for podcast.
Alicantiente.
Do you think she's naked under there?
What?
Caliente.
Brian!
Are you naked?
No, stop. It's even if I was, it doesn't matter. I have garments on.
I guess if you got horny, it would just soak up really easy.
Oh,
Brian,
my
why
God.
Are you so
cut.
Brian, this is too dirty.
Cut.
Brian, we can't be that dirty.
Thank you for listening. We've had to cut to commercial.
This is upsetting Esther.
Here at IHOP, we like to provide you with... Actually, no, fuck IHOP.
Esther, see, now you're getting pulled into it. Esther is getting pulled into it now.
Dear Lord, please forgive me for my sins.
I mean, this is going dark. It's going dirty.
Yeah.
This is not positive energy.
What happened to when we started and talked about caramel apples?
Yeah, I'd like to, you know, ask you about that.
Ask me.
Esther, I really am going to miss seeing your car, which I always look for.
Thank you.
And hopefully we'll continue to keep podcasting.
Obviously.
You know, will you text me when I'm over where I'm at?
I mean, will you your number be the same or does he have to change it?
I'm going to keep it the same.
What were you going to ask me about?
You're happy staying in on a Friday night or a Saturday night? You don't
yes.
feel like you're missing out on things?
Sometimes, but sometimes you feel that way, but you just stay. What are you going to do? Go out?
I mean, do you feel that because you're in quote unquote show business, you're living in Los Angeles, do you feel like, oh, maybe I should go to this party?
Well, it's never hit me until this, because all throughout high school and college, I never wanted to go and party, and there was never an upside to going, so I always felt good about my decision and my lifestyle. But yes, being in show business, supposedly, you're supposed to go out and meet people, and, you know, that helps you, but I do not do that, and that's the one downside to being a granny at age 24.
Well, you're saying granny, meaning that grannies stay home.
Honestly, if I could just snap my fingers and just have the granny lifestyle, like my great grandma used to have this tiny apartment, and she would bake pies sometimes, and she was kind of out of it, and maybe throw some cats in there. Like that would be perfect. Never have to leave, and then maybe visitors sometimes. Diapers and just a really calm lifestyle. Basic TV channels available.
That makes sense.
Yeah, books, maybe memorabilia from your life that you look through, read old journals. It just seems very calm.
Grandchildren?
Well, for me, hopefully not, but it seems like that would be, I would need that to be a granny.
I mean, you do babysit, so you have to be somewhat decent with kids, but do you think you would ever have babies?
I'm not ruling it out, but it would probably be in like 100 years, at least. No, I'm later, in a while, but yeah. I was thinking about this, that what if the way that I behave like a kid is my instinct, like... I want to have a baby, so I'm like treating myself like I'm a baby.
Esther, so when you go home for the night, is this, I mean, you're doing comedy, obviously. You're a comedian, you're a performer.
Yes.
You'll still go out and do your sets, but you go up early generally.
Yeah, I try. And I just went through a 6-month period. An 11 month period where I was doing the late sets.
You had a period for 11 months?
Oh. Brody.
You had a period for 11 months? Go ahead. I'm sorry.
I had an 11 month
period. 11 month period.
You have a lot of red socks now, I bet.
Brian, I mean.
How do socks get red?
It's a lot of period coming out of you.
Not into your socks. I have red underwear. Yeah, maybe that. Because I don't know when my period comes, so I can't.
Guys, this isn't a sex show. This is people talking like adults, having a meal at a restaurant like Olive Garden.
Which I love.
Which is very good.
Wouldn't mind going there.
Unlimited breadsticks, bottomless.
Salad.
Solid.
What?
Salad.
That's not what you said.
I said solid. Hi, do you have a... can I get a Caesar salad? Can I have some blue cheese for my salad?
Caramel. Wait, what kind of apples?
Caramel.
What else?
Solid.
No.
Do you have any solid caramel? Caramel? Solid caramel? So what I'm saying is, Esther, you'll do your set and you'll get home. You honestly like to be in bed?
Yes.
Early?
Yes, as early as possible.
And your bed is, it is fluffy and it's got pillows and it's a sanctuary.
Well, it's not fluffier than the normal bed and it's not extra pillows.
Crustier, though.
No, but it does have snowman sheets.
Is that to cover up what's on it?
No, what would be on it? Maybe there's crumbs from time to time, but my roommate helps me take care of those.
How is your roommate? You guys are getting along well?
Yeah.
Do you think she'll help me with my new apartment?
Maybe.
I could borrow her and we could go to Target or something like that. Is she good at that? Picking out things for a kitchen? Or is it more for organization?
You can contact her directly and ask her. I think she's good at everything.
I need help with this new apartment. I need a bed. I need a couch. I need a chair. I'm going to do these
iPad
things.
I need an
iPad Mini. Add it to your wish list.
Oh, yeah.
Do you think somebody out there would buy Esther an iPad Mini?
I'm sure.
Why don't you put it on your wish list? Can you do that? Is there...
I don't think they have iPad minis yet on the wish list because that's competition of their... They have like an iPad version.
Oh, Amazon does?
Yeah.
Yeah, I could see that.
Yeah.
What are some things on a wish list that might be cool to get from Amazon? I mean, they have everything, right?
Well, Brian made me a wish list.
I helped you make one.
Could you have... Are there tennis shoes on there? T-shirts?
Mine is stuffed animals, snacks... and bath supplies.
Have you received any yet?
No, I just made it like 5 minutes ago.
Brian, did you do a wish list for Amazon?
I think I had one once, but I don't really.
Did you receive anything?
I don't think. Well, I mean, I've done it for Death Squad before, where we had things for the studio, like headphones and things that we needed for the studio. And yeah, a lot of people bought stuff off that for us.
Really?
Yeah.
How much would they? I mean, how much would they pay for an item?
Well, it depends. Some of the items were really cheap and other items were a little bit more expensive. And for the more expensive ones, I would like do a commercial for their business or their website or, you know, so I'd get, you know, if they bought something off that list, I pretty much made a commercial for them, you know, for Death Squad. So.
Will you see if mine's up?
I was trying to search for yours, Esther, and maybe it's because we just did it. It's not available yet, but I will.
It's called Little Esther.
I will tweet the link of your one right now so people can find it. We should take a look. You want to look and see what she added on it, bro?
Yeah.
All right.
Uh-oh.
Let's see what she added on it. Yeah, I tried to search for it. So if you want to look at her link right now, maybe you could retweet it, Esther.
Okay.
But I just did it. So here is Esther's list. And she looks like she has Cheez-Its or what is that?
Those are cheddar bunnies.
Cheddar bunnies. So, I mean, that's, why are they so expensive? $17 for, oh, it's a pack of four.
That's all they had there. Then there's graham crackers, chocolate milk, chips.
So mostly bunnies. Food items on your list.
Chocolate peanut butter.
Are you seeing this, Brody? It's all food items.
No, it's not all
food. How are they going to deliver
cinnamon
food
crispies.
Items?
Oh my God.
What's this?
You added that.
Oh, a rechargeable massager for your neck.
You added that. Take that down. Brian, take that down. Oh my God,
hamster.
You added dirty stuff.
No,
take
I didn't.
It down. Yes, you did. You added the hamster.
Brian, what did you do?
And then you added the dirty stuff. I added the Britney Spears album and the Sephora gift card and the bath fuzzies. But you added the dirty stuff. Take it off.
Brian, that is not cool
that
at all.
That is not cool at all. Take the dirty stuff off.
She can't have that. She's auditioning for things. She has management.
You take it off. I don't want that.
Right. Buy it for you.
No.
That is uncomfortable.
Yeah, Brian.
Do you have do you have a vibrator, Esther?
What?
Put it on my wish list.
You will use it for her? Use it to her?
I'll use it myself. You can put a vibrator on your crotch and it feels good.
I don't think it feels good.
You don't think so?
No, I don't think vibration works for me. My dad used to have...
It tickles.
Back when I was younger, I was looking for new ways to masturbate. And my dad had like one of those massagers. You ever see it with the springs? That you put your hand in like the springs and it's like this big metal thing on top that vibrates. And what you're supposed to do is like when you give a massage...
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
They do that at like Floyd's barbershop.
Yeah. And I did it to try to masturbate all the time growing up. But it was something with the springs and the dick. It just was not good. I can't remember.
Ew.
Yeah. Ew. Why can't you just put a vibration on your, like a little massager you'd get at Brookstone?
I don't think vibration just feels good.
Like, does for me.
Really? You like the vibration?
I'm going to get back into it.
Oh.
I've not been vibrating myself like I should.
Is your hand on your penis right now, Brody?
No.
What are you doing?
I just put my leg up. I'm being comfortable.
Get off the iPad, Esther.
I'm trying to figure out how
Esther,
to
put the put the iPad down. That's rude. That's like me reading my tweets
you
during the
guys,
show.
You guys, I was trying to fix the glitches in the system, okay? Because Brian added dirty massagers to my wish list, making me look like I'm a dirty person.
You're not.
I wouldn't publicly ask for that. I asked for snacks. I asked for cheddar
bunnies. You need to take care of yourself, Esther. I was just trying to help you out.
I do take care of myself.
I think that is the Hitachi wand is one of the nicest ones. This is a mini one that you can just keep in your purse or, you know, it's just
like
a smaller.
I like mini things.
Yeah, it's a smaller version for you because you are a smaller girl. And
do you have a mini fleshlight for me?
I do.
Do they? I haven't used one yet. Are they good?
They are good. I'll get you one.
Could you get me one?
Yeah, I'll get you one.
And that
can I
just,
get a fleshlight?
You don't need one.
So yeah, the fleshlight, you stick your penis in there,
mm-hmm.
And
oh
it feels
God.
It feels.
Brody, stop! You're getting on the Brian
you're getting her
train.
Wet.
Oh my God,
Brian, that is graphic.
I'm gone.
Do you guys like beef jerky and stuff?
Yeah. Wait
are
a second.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Where is this going?
No, do you? Do you like beef jerky?
Yes, I like beef jerky.
Brody and I like
here,
turkey jerky.
You guys should try this sometime. This is cranberry and buffalo, and it's from Onnit, but they just sent me a box of it, and I fucking love it.
Natural what? Buffalo cranberry bar.
Do you have one that's not spicy?
They're not spicy at all.
It says hot.
It's not. It's not. It really isn't spicy at all. I don't know why it says spicy, but it's really good. It's the cranberry. For
is it a dessert?
Good.
Is it a treat?
It's
is
like
it?
A it's a energy type thing.
You had it, Esther? Oh, Esther
no,
heard treat.
She's mess.
Esther heard the word treat and she got excited. Esther, put your phone down, please.
Brody.
Be professional. This is a podcast.
Okay.
No, you can do whatever you want. So, Brian,
yeah.
A fleshlight is basically You get erect and you stick your...
Yeah, it's just a way to masturbate. Instead of using your hand, they have like this patinized rubber that feels really realistic.
Uh-huh.
And so it's just a better way to masturbate.
And when you ejaculate, where does that go?
It goes inside of it.
Can I smell that?
Oh, it does?
Mm-hmm.
And then you just wash it out?
Yeah, you actually have a hole in the bottom of it, so you just blow it through. Taste a bite.
Wait, I don't want to blow.
You want to try it?
You're telling me you have to blow a fleshlight?
No, you don't have to blow it. I mean, you could if you wanted to.
I'm going to blow where I just put my penis.
No, like one end you put on the faucet and you blow the water through it, so it just...
Could you kiss a fleshlight on the lips?
Yeah.
So you,
do
how
you
often,
prefer a mouth or
how
a vagina
often do you
one?
Use your fleshlight? Every time you masturbate?
To be honest, I don't use it as much anymore.
Why? It's just too
they're
much of a hassle?
They're not sponsored by me.
Right.
So one of the good things is that I would just get so many free fleshlights that I would fuck one, and then I'd just be lazy and not clean it and just get another one.
You lazy?
You wouldn't clean it?
No.
You lazy and not clean something?
I would just bring it here at the studio and let people like touch it and look at it and in my head just laugh because they're touching my old cum and stuff.
That's disgusting.
I can't believe I'm about to eat this.
When you have sex with a fleshlight, is your orgasm bigger?
It's bigger. It's frothier.
Oh my God, I'm about to throw up.
From that or the food?
Both. The food is fine, but frothier? Are you fucking disgusting?
I've been having frothier loads lately.
Ew. And why is this like juicy?
It's the cranberry.
Ugh, I want to go home.
Esther, no, you have to power through this podcast. So how are... Okay, so, Brian, you went up at the Comedy Store last night.
Do you have other snacks?
How often do you get to do that?
Brian, do you have other snacks?
Once or twice a week.
I need some...
That's good.
...to get me snacks on my wish list.
Yeah.
Once or twice a week isn't bad.
Yeah, usually once.
How was it, or how is it there? You like the main... I mean, the
last night was
room?
Last night was interesting because I thought of a new bit while eating out. I went out to dinner with Dana DiRamon. And somebody sent me a photo, and I made a bit. It was one of those ones where you think of an idea, and then you think of like 9 tags for it, and just kind of wrote itself type of kind of bit.
Yeah.
And then I was like, I want to try this really bad, so I went to the Comedy Store, and they let me go up. And I did it for my first time, and I didn't even really write it out. I kind of just did like a really sloppy version of what it would eventually be.
Yeah.
But it was it felt really good, and I think it's a really funny bit, and now I'm like psyched to go back on stage sometime and try it again.
That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
Getting those new bits and...
Trying them out.
I wish I had more bits. I had a good set last night at the Improv. I did a show for Pitbull Rescue. Rob Delaney was on it. Eddie Pepitone. Rebecca Corey. Packed house.
Cool.
You know, I was telling Ari last night, it's like, I get nervous at the Comedy Store sometimes, whether it be the main room or the original room, if it's packed in there. Because I don't get those opportunities to perform much when it's packed.
Right.
I'm used to going up later in the show when it's, you know, over the hump.
Right.
The room's been broken. And then I go up and I thrive in those situations. But you do them so many times, you get used to that energy. And then they go, okay, you're going to go up at 10:30 in the main room on a Saturday night. And it's packed in there. And it's like a whole different energy. So... When you go out on the road, like you were in Seattle this weekend in San Francisco, how do you deal with that energy, the big crowds in there? Is that just, I mean, is it different when it's a theater?
It was really ridiculous. I mean, one of the places in Seattle, it was 3 stories, you know? So like you're looking out at, well, you couldn't see anybody, but it's just...
You couldn't see them?
You could hear them like above you. You know,
right.
Like way up. There was, I mean... I think I have some photos.
You were at the Moore Theater in Seattle.
Yeah.
2nd Avenue.
Yes. And then we were in San Francisco the night before, and that was also a huge theater. But, yeah, it was – it's really – what's really weird is you have to just do your bits different. You know, like when you're at the Comedy Store and there's like 7 people in there or whatever, you have a different timing than you do, say, when you have – so many people, you can't tell if they're done laughing or not. You can't tell if they're laughing because, like, the sound's just
right.
So weird that you really don't know what's going on. So, yeah, it's interesting doing that stuff. And
I feel probably doing the big auditorium is easier than doing a packed comedy club. Comedy clubs are intimate, and I'm just talking about in terms of easier. If you ask most comedians, they probably want to perform in a club, a packed club. Doing the auditoriums, yes, it's better for your career and better for you as a person.
Yeah, so that's the place that we played in. I think this was
in San Francisco. That's huge.
Yeah, this was two stories.
And it goes straight back.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then the place that we did in Seattle was, I think, twice as big or...
More theater.
Yeah, more theater. Was a lot bigger than
that. I saw Louis C.K. there.
Yeah?
A couple years ago.
That's cool.
Yeah, that's a famous theater.
Is it?
I think, well, for Seattle it is.
That's cool.
It's been around a while. I think Pearl Jam shot one of their earlier videos there. Even Flow, when he climbs up.
Can my baby be?
You know, when he climbs up the curtain or the wall?
Right.
That's the Moore Theater. That's where you played last night or the night before.
I mean, here's somebody that was sitting. No, I don't want to show you that. But there was. It was weird because people were saying that they were sitting on the third story, and like they tweeted me pictures of what I looked like.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, and it's just like this like little dot, and it's like it's weird for a comedy not being able to see the comic, because a lot of jokes I think rely on the face of the comic, you know, just the how his face looks when he's talking and like little facial things. So it's weird when you don't have that, you're almost just listening to it.
Some shows, like if you play a huge theater, they're going to have cameras. You'll be up on video screen.
Yeah.
Have you done any shows with Joe where you guys are on video screen?
The West Palm Improv, it's so big that halfway back, they start having televisions on the top so you can see the comics.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's ridiculously long.
How nice is that club?
It's nice, but I think it's too big. I think it's... Yeah, I don't think people really want to come to a comedy club and look... at TVs.
How far is West Palm from Miami?
I think like it's pretty close, like 30 minutes or something like that.
What was the crowd like? Do you remember?
Rowdy.
Drunk, oh, they were?
Loud. A lot of big butts.
Big butts?
And you can't deny.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of Cubans and stuff down there.
They would come out to the show? Mm-hmm. They're rowdier, right?
Yeah. I think all the clubs in Florida are a lot rowdier.
They say that, like, Miami Improv's a tough room.
Yeah.
I haven't heard about West Palm.
I did it.
You did both? You did Miami Improv also?
No, I did West Palm, though. I mean, I performed it, but I didn't. I've been to Miami Improv. I just didn't perform there.
Yeah, I've heard about that club. I'd like to go do clubs. Esther, what are you doing?
She's not paying attention.
I'm not doing anything.
She's got
Esther,
an
we,
iPad
I mean,
and
we
phone.
Came here. Brian and I are putting our
you
time in.
You guys were
in.
Talking about big
comedy
stuff.
Well, that, I mean, yeah, you're doing comedy too. I see your name on the list at the Comedy Store. You're going up. You're getting laughs.
Look, to be honest, I took a bite of that spicy thing, and I just feel dirty.
I didn't eat any of mine.
I feel like a dirty girl.
Why?
I just feel gross.
It's not spicy.
It's spicy and it was juicy, and then you were talking about frothy stuff, and it just made me feel like I did something wrong.
I'm going to have to side with Esther on that.
Thank you.
How is your have your workouts been, Esther? Give the audience an update on that. You've been going to Crunch, right? Crunch Fitness?
No.
Do you not want me to announce that?
I'm not going there anymore.
Why?
Because I just don't like it.
Esther, what happened? You can't be that way. You have to be an adult.
How's your relationship with Brie Olsen been?
Good.
Have you had a threesome yet with her and her boyfriend? Because I noticed that she tweeted something like how they go online and look for threesomes.
No, we haven't had a threesome. I don't want to have a threesome with my friend.
How often are you talking to her?
We text almost every day, and we hang out sometimes.
Where do you guys go when you hang out?
Stores.
What stores? Shopping?
Food stores.
Food stores?
Yeah.
What, you know, Gelson's?
No.
Trader Joe's?
I shouldn't reveal where.
Ralph's? There's a bunch of Trader Joe's.
John's? You go to John's?
No,
they don't go there.
I can't reveal where my famous friend goes.
She's famous? She was married to Charlie Sheen?
She's a famous porn star, ex-porn star.
She did regular major porn?
Yes.
She was, how I found out about her was it through you? I don't think it was through you. Maybe
possibly.
I think it was through Trailer or Trailer Vixen.
Who's that?
She introduced me, my ex. She introduced me to her Twitter because her Twitter page was notorious for being extremely dirty.
Yeah.
Like
Brie Olson?
Yeah, like she would be like at airport, have dried cum still all over my face. I want to look, this guy just walked by.
Let me retweet that.
Yeah.
But she's not like that anymore.
She went through a phase of that?
That's how she was all the time. And then she started dating Charlie Sheen during that big Charlie Sheen craziness.
And she quit porn.
Didn't they get into a fight?
Yeah. And then she quit porn. And then now she's just like a normal girl. It's kind of weird to see the transformation. She's still hot and beautiful and all that shit.
You guys talk about her past life, Esther? Or is it all common, current, in the now?
I did a podcast with her, and we talked. We just talk about girl stuff when we hang out.
You did a podcast today, or somewhere, something with Fahim. He's in a new video, Fahim Anwar.
Yeah, he's funny.
He's funny?
Mm-hmm.
You have a crush on him?
No. No, I don't have a crush.
Are you crushing on anybody?
No. No, not really. I like snacks.
What kind of snacks?
Cheddar bunnies, cinnamon crunchy stuff, graham crackers.
Are you exercising?
Sometimes.
You're going to ballet?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Where do you write your jokes? In bed?
In my head.
You don't put them down anywhere? Esther, what is...
Brody, tell us about your exercising.
Okay, yes, positive energy. I hike. I took a different route today. I went hiking with Ari. I went hiking with Matt Edgar. I went hiking with Carlos, and we went to Runyon, and we took the difficult route. I didn't want to do it, but they talked me into it, and I did the difficult route. I got up this morning. I went to Coffee Bean. I hung out there for a couple hours. I saw Jesus, a.k.a. Kevin Lee Light. I did my Twitter. I'm writing more jokes on Twitter. I promoted my t-shirts. I then went home and took a junior nap. And then I went on the hike and we did the hard route. Is that Esther?
What's going on? What is that?
That's you.
Is that you shopping for tampons?
Yes.
At Rite Aid?
At Target.
Is it weird getting tampons?
No. I buy special tampons for teenage girls.
So when you have your when you buy your tampons and you wait in line at Target, do you go to a female cashier when you have tampons?
No, I am very confident when I buy my tampons. I'm very confident when I buy anything embarrassing. It's just you got to sell it. You got to act like a pro, act like you do it all the time, and it's really not embarrassing. When I was in high school, I had to buy a pregnancy test, and I just did it, but then the lady was like, oh, come here and I'll check it out secretly.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I mean, when I go to...
That's my Kardashian jumpsuit.
When I get condoms at Target, when I pick out the line, I look for the hottest chick.
Oh, I got a condom update.
In the cashier.
Really?
Yeah, I want her to see that I got condoms. I go, check this out. I've got condoms. I make love. I wear a condom and I use my Fleshlight at the same time. Is that a good idea to wear a condom while penetrating a Fleshlight? Esther, you're laughing a lot tonight. It makes me feel good that you're laughing.
Good.
You're happy.
Yeah.
Last time you got too stoned. Have you been smoking the weed, Brody, still, or are you?
That's a great question, Brian. I am not high. I'm not under the influence of marijuana. Did I smoke pot earlier today? Yes, I did.
Put that down.
Brian, put that away.
Put it away.
Brian, don't make me smoke pot.
Look, I'm going to just say I was having a lot of fun until I had that weird spicy thing that was juicy and scary.
I'm on Lamictal.
What's
I don't know what
likes. What's your condom update?
Condom update. This is something that I forgot happened and you just reminded me to do it. Like 6 months ago, I found a Magnum condom, and I never wore a Magnum condom. Magnum condoms are bigger condoms. And I always thought when you put a condom on, the fact that if it's like tight and you know, fits to your dick, that makes it better because it makes it feel like you don't have a condom on. You know what I mean? So it's like always tight and stuff like that. I wore a Magnum condom and it was like the perfect fit and it wasn't tight. Like it didn't feel like my dick was like losing blood supply and stuff.
This is an inappropriate update.
Yeah.
Have you ever tried a Magnum condom, Brody? Because like I was always scared. I was always scared of
it. It makes me feel a little uncomfortable having Esther around when you're talking about your penis and condoms in the same sentence.
This is inappropriate.
It's not cool.
It's uncool.
It's uncool.
It's not necessary.
It's unnecessary.
I thought when you said a condom update, it was going to be something like technology.
Fresh and happy. Something fresh and happy.
Fresh and happy.
Lambskin based.
Yeah, like something healthier.
You tried lambskin based before?
A specific.
Yeah, I get it at Zanku Chicken.
I feel so dirty from that juicy thing.
Can I get a lambskin chicken? Do people know what lamps, when you say lambskin, do they just assume condom?
Yeah.
So if I say I get a lambskin. No, Brian, don't make me smoke pot. Don't make me do it. This is uncomfortable. This is peer pressure at its ultimate level. I smoke pot or I'll tell you what. Just make sure I go and drop off my furniture tonight.
Do it.
You know? Esther, what's happening?
Oh.
I can't get it. What? Stop.
She needs mouth to mouth.
No, no.
She's Brody. Choking on water.
Brody, no. What is going on? Put it away.
I didn't touch it. It's just sitting there.
Brian, take it back. I just choked, okay? What's that?
A Mountain Dew.
What? Ooh, I like that.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. That's internet rape.
Oh, my God. Ow. Ow.
Esther, are you okay? Brian, that was like a violation on camera.
She just had an orgasm. Look at her. She's laying back with her feet up now.
I am not. Why did you trick me into thinking you were giving me a Mountain Dew? That was the stupidest trick ever.
Esther, are you okay?
No,
it's the
I'm
old
not
Mountain
okay.
Dew trick.
Okay, I have really sore breasts, and you made me hurt them. Okay? I have a breast soreness.
Brody told me to text me and told me to do it.
I didn't say to do that. Barack Obama sent me another message.
He's not saying anything to me.
Be the difference today. Help people find their polling place and know where to volunteer. Retweet. How can I volunteer and vote the same day?
TMZ had a poll today. Who are you going to vote for? Who do you want to win? I was kind of surprised at the number, not because it wasn't who I thought was going to be higher up, but because it wasn't that big of a difference. Like it was like 53% to whatever.
Uh-oh.
And TMZ, I would think, would be more of an Obama, more Obama people probably read TMZ. So I'm thinking, based on that, we're probably going to have Mitt as the president.
No.
If he wins.
No.
I'll tell you what. Tomorrow I'm going to go vote. I'm planning on it. Even our vote, some people would say it doesn't matter, especially here in the state of California. But there's other things to vote for than just the presidency, so you should get in there and do it. And I am planning on voting.
Yes, on Prop 37, so that our genetically modified foods are labeled, because people who smoke cigarettes have to relabel saying that their food's going to give them cancer and kill them, or their cigarettes give them cancer. And I think that fat losers like me who eat garbage should have to read a label that says their food is genetically modified and it could hurt you. So yes, I'm Prop 37. I can't vote myself because I'm a lazy person. No, because I'm not a legal resident of California, so I can't vote for it because it's only for California.
Did you vote in Illinois?
No, I did not.
So you're not voting?
I'm not a voter.
You're not voting for the president tomorrow?
I can't vote.
Why?
I'm a criminal.
Esther, and if you don't want to talk about it, you don't have to. I mean, it's a very personal thing, your vote. Are you voting tomorrow?
I can't vote.
Did you do?
I forgot to register in time.
All right. I'm registered. Don't you get registered to vote when you go to the DMV or something like that?
I don't really know.
Or when you sign up for cable?
I don't have TV.
When you sign up for cable, does that register to vote? No. When you sign up for cable, does that register you to vote?
No.
Maybe I'll tweet that out. I've been doing more jokes on Twitter.
Wait, that was a joke?
Yeah, it's a joke. It's what I do. I do jokes.
I'm the only one that I'm really concerned about right is the condoms and porn.
Yeah.
I think that's pretty fucked up.
That's scary.
I like to see it natural.
Yeah.
Well, right?
That's, well, that and I just, because if that happens, you know, all the porn stars are going to leave L.A., you know?
What do you mean?
Because they're not going to be able to work. No one's, I mean.
They're going to go to, they're going to go to other cities. They're going to go to.
Where do they shoot porn other than L.A.?
I don't know. Vegas, maybe? I have no, Florida? I don't even know.
But it's only L.A. City. They can go to another city. They can go to Glendale. They can go to Pasadena.
It's Prop B. It's California Prop B. Vote no on it. I think it's only for California.
What is it? Freedom of porn? Freedom of condom?
It's just because they're making people not only wear condoms in porn, but they're making them wear like dental dams.
Oh,
if they have
God.
To do blowjob videos. If you and your wife want to broadcast like on the webcams of you having sex, it's going to make you have to have a permit that costs up to like $60,000 just to have like public sex on a webcam. Even.
Really?
Yeah. And there's going to be all these like extra fines. And like, it's not just the condom thing. It's like the condom thing's one thing, but it's also like a ton of other bullshit things.
That can't pass.
If it passes, it will ruin porn. Porn will be dead.
But some of the biggest watchers of porn are Republicans.
Maybe.
Wouldn't you say?
Well, I don't know.
I think so.
How do we know?
Secretly. They talk about they wouldn't be into it, but they may be. I'm more on the conservative side. That's where I kind of lean on. But I'm going to vote for Obama. I don't want the change right now.
Yeah, I don't think it's worth the change. Let's just keep it the same.
Let's not rock the boat.
Right.
He's doing a good job.
He's doing an okay job. But
people like him. You know,
he's got 4 years experience.
Let him
just fucking do another 4 years. I don't think it's going to be a big difference either way.
What if racists all come out this time?
Yeah, maybe.
And vote for Romney?
Yeah.
Maybe this is going to be a big race one.
Black versus white. Like the whites are saying, like, let's just get it over with and do it.
Yeah.
I mean, it could happen. I mean, he could win the popular vote.
Well, I mean, Obama barely beat him on TMZ, and that's mostly Obama readers, I would imagine. I don't think many Republicans want to know what Lindsay Lohan's vagina looks like.
I mean, how much different does a president make? Aren't they more of just a figurehead at this point?
Yeah.
What is Romney going to do different than Obama? I don't want to get political.
He's going to put women in binders and not let us get abortions.
That doesn't happen. You could still get one. You can still go to Mexico.
That's true.
Yeah.
No, I'm not going to Mexico for an abortion.
It's
going to
be like dangerous
right
abortions.
In my neighborhood.
That's all that's going to happen. Is going to be dangerous abortions.
I want a neighborhood abortion.
I try not to get involved in politics. It's just, I'd like to say, like, if you ask me in your heart, Brody, are you pro-life or pro-choice? In my heart, I'm pro-choice. But I know that may upset my fan base. I have 37,000 followers on Twitter. If I get political and let them know that I'm either pro-choice or pro-life, and I let them know I'm pro-choice, I'm into the woman deciding, I could lose followers. I probably have conservative Christian followers.
To me, that doesn't matter. I want to be myself and spread my message.
And what's your message?
I don't know. Snacks are good.
I knew you were going to say snacks.
Baths are good.
You did a bath. What is it? Bathetician last night or something?
Bathematician.
Bathlete. Made your bush disappear.
That's wow.
Brian, again, you keep going there with that talk, that sex talk. You
that
should
was
be Prop 32.
Nowhere. Yeah. Vote Prop 32. No.
What's
Brian.
A bathematician?
Yeah, you were doing some tweets last night, and I retweeted them.
Thank you, Brody. Yeah, I'm a bathlete. I take baths. I take multiple baths in one day. I'm a bathlete, a bathematician, little town of Bethlehem.
Do you check how many retweets you get on a tweet?
Not really. Not. I mean, if I'm bored, and yeah.
Can I ask, or do you know what your highest amount of retweets?
I don't know.
For a particular tweet may have been.
I don't. I actually don't know.
I just kind of like got into that business of checking my retweets because I want to get, I feel like I can write more jokes. And now I'm curious to see how these jokes are. See, I'm trying to turn myself into a joke writer. I'm trying to work that portion of my brain to write jokes as opposed to just giving reality updates and talking to my fans. Like most of the time on Twitter, I communicate with my fans. I'm letting them know, and I speak as though they already are aware of me and what I do.
I like a healthy mix of that.
So yeah, it's now I'm trying to mix in jokes. And then I did a joke the other night. I got 250 retweets.
Wow.
It shattered my record. Of 160.
What was the joke?
The joke was something along the lines of, I used to be in the metric. I used to have a foot fetish, but now I'm into the metric system.
That's funny.
Something like that. But, and it got me, yeah, 250 retweets.
That's a really good joke.
Yeah, it's silly. I'm sure something of that nature has been done. But I made the effort to say, I'm going to write more jokes that aren't necessarily Brody-based and not necessarily an update or reality tweet. I'll still do my updates. I'll still do my reality tweets. I'll still do my replies back to my fans. But you will start seeing an influx of jokes that anybody could tell across the board.
I'm really happy to hear this. I think that the world needs this.
Yeah, but I'm not a great joke writer.
I think you are a great joke writer.
I'm okay, but you know what?
I think you're one of the best.
Well, thank you, but looking at, let's say, the Sulk, Alex Sulkin, or looking at Eli Braden, or looking at...
Why are we going to compare ourselves to others who are much different than us?
But they're great.
But they're great. They are great in a different way, and you're great, too.
They're
just as great as them, but in a different way.
Well, I'll say this. In terms of joke writing, maybe personality, you can say you're great. If they're doing when they do their personality tweets... Okay, I can hold my own in that ballpark. Personality tweets, reality tweets, things of that nature. But when it comes to straight joke writing, Eli Braden and Alex Sulkin are head and shoulders above me. And I'd like to kind of at least aspire to get to that point or in that direction.
It's okay to aspire to that, but I don't think you should compare. You can't compare and be creative. I think
compare and despair.
You want to just be yourself.
And I am that.
And nobody can be you better than you.
I've seen people do impressions of me.
Not better.
Steve Renazzisi does a good one.
But he can't do it better than you.
Yes. Positive energy. You got it. Hashtag speech.
So I got a website for you guys to check out. If you guys like Instagram a lot.
Yeah. I'm into Instagram.
There's a website called, I think it's called Statigram. It's STATIGR.AM, and it's you pretty much sign in with your Instagram address, and it's just a nice way to look at it online using your laptop, because usually you can't really do much on, you know, it's only for like iPhones and stuff.
Yeah,
and so you can like see all the people you follow. You can also see statistics, like what your biggest how many, you know, likes are. Like, I have 89 photos, I've received 13,000 likes, and it just shows you, like, there's just a lot of cool statistics. If you're a statistic guy, you can see like what photos were the biggest, the people you follow, what was their biggest, and it's
just another time waster.
Yeah, it's,
I like
if you're into Instagram though, the viewer is the thing I like the most, just being able to see like everybody's photos all, you know,
big
in a row. Yeah, see them big, like here's the girl I'm in love with now, her skin diamond.
Oh, my God.
And I mean, she's just this beautiful black chick.
Oh, my God. Come here, Ebony.
You guys.
And
God, I want to use a fleshlight on you.
And here's, yeah, look at this one.
They're sitting on a couch waiting.
She's waiting for you.
And you could zoom in.
Yeah.
What happens if I forget my Instagram password, which I've already done?
I'm sure you can find it.
Who's that at the Laugh Factory performing?
Nick Youssef.
Who took that photo?
I don't know.
He's a good comedian.
You know, I was just talking about this the other day. I haven't seen Nick Youssef in a long time do comedy, so I heard he changed his style recently. Somebody told me that.
He may have, I don't know. But I think he's a pretty good comedian. I like watching him.
Here's a Jewish girl that I'm friends with that, if I can load this stupid...
stupid laptop.
Why is it not loading? Is it the site?
No, it's just laptop.
Oh, my gosh.
Her name's Casey Ramone, and she does, you would like her. She's a blonde Jew.
Oh.
She's really hot. And
I want to feed you matzo sticks.
She's only 19.
Oh, does she have a younger sister? Oh, my God. Where is she? I'm going to fly there tonight.
And she's Jackie Gold's cousin.
Who's Jackie Gold?
Comedian.
You know, I've heard the name. Look at those cheeks.
Yeah, their little butt cheeks.
Oh, they're so soft. I just want to squeeze them. Oh, I want to squeeze your cheeks.
Poop comes out of butts.
I know. I mean, yeah, I know.
But why do guys like butts if poop comes out of them?
Because it's so taboo. It's wrong. It's like 10% gay.
Why do you like dick when they go in butts?
Okay, that was a total off track. You got off track. Okay?
Got off track.
I'm sorry, when I just heard Brody moaning over there and rubbing his leg.
God, these guys retweet it real quick. Like, Dat Dan, the guy already said, oh, I want to use a fleshlight on you. He put that up right away.
I love it when people quote stuff from podcasts. I think it's really fun.
Oh, I got another one. Jesse Roy said, Brody has a thing for Casey Ramone. Ha, ha, ha. Hashtag feed him matzo sticks. There's no such thing as matzo sticks. I made it up. That was awesome. Great episode tonight, Brody. We're still going. How dare you?
I already tweeted your Amazon wish list, Esther.
Oh, I didn't see it.
Haha, do it. Blaze that shit, Brody. Stay high. How? No, I'm not doing it.
Why not?
Because it's just going to tweak me. And I have to call my psychologist later.
Do you have a meeting with her today, or is it just like you have to call her and say, what's up?
Just,
have you tried to put the moves on your psychiatrist? She was a pretty girl.
She's my psychologist, and no.
That might be kind of hot.
Yes, I was mentioned on the podcast. Yes, you were, Dat Dan. I love the band Matzo Sticks. Is there a band, Matzo Sticks? That's a good joke. I thought they were real, not Jewish. Matzo Sticks. Matzo Sticks, my new favorite word. This is a great episode. Sticks, Matzo Sticks are real in Canada. I'm feeling pretty good about myself. No, I'm not going to hook up with my psychologist. I won't cross that line. She is helpful. She checks in on me. I think that doing this podcast at least once, I mean, not at least, but doing this podcast here with Esther, here with Brian, and then doing the Ice House Chronicles when you do that, doing the show here at the Ice House Annex or the main room when that happens. These are all activities that have contributed to my stability, me coming back. You know, I'm doing Chelsea Lately again on the 29th of November. It'll be my fifth time doing it since I got out of the hospital. And so for me, it's just all about structure. The scary part, and I'm not going to go into it because we've done it before, is like, I'm still not myself. Even though I'm having my comedy, my podcasting, my merchandise, my career, if you will, is I'm doing a sketch for a Comedy Central show on Thursday. Even though my career is going as well as it is now, as it has ever gone, I still don't feel completely right. And I think part of that is the medication. But the medication is helping my stand-up, so it's kind of a trade-off. And I'm trying to create structure. I'm trying to stay busy, and we'll see what happens. But I don't want to make this a whole, you know, thing about my meds. I'm just thankful that, you know, Esther said yes. She was proactive today to doing this podcast. Brian, you know, he's busy. He was in Seattle and San Francisco and doing comedy at the Comedy Store, doing podcasts with Joe Rogan. He could have said no, but he didn't. He said yes. I want Brody's positive energy here in my studio, and I will bring it. You want me there? I do it. Correct, Esther?
Yes. I like pink sparkles.
What's that?
Well, I just was, Brian, what is this? It's a pretty color.
It's pink.
But what is this?
It's a light.
It changes colors.
Yeah. And it's rechargeable.
Are you sponsored by them?
No. Should I be? Light? Have you ever been sponsored by a light?
No.
Yeah, I am.
Fleshlight.
I'm sponsored by a light.
Brian.
By light and positivity.
Would you say IKEA is a good store?
No.
Why?
Christmas, well, it depends what you want. If you want like miscellaneous like little things, yeah, it's fine.
Tchotchkes?
Tchotchkes. If you, but like for like furniture and things like that,
it's I think not it's good.
No, like this girl I know had bought an IKEA bed.
Uh-huh.
She had to put it together. It was a million pieces. Fucking was a pretty cost, kind of a large amount of money for IKEA. And then like I fucked her in it, and the bed fell apart.
Whoa!
Bed just fell apart,
Brian.
And then we had to like put it back together the next day. And then of course it happened like 1,000 more times.
The sex part.
Yeah, like I just kept on breaking. Every time we would fuck, it would just break the bed.
Brian, make love.
Make love. Every time we'd make love in her butt.
Or
kiss.
Brian, you always have to like get graphic like that.
No, we're done here. Okay?
I mean, Esther is young.
Esther, I didn't say it was you. But way to out yourself.
That's so disgusting.
Brian, Esther's parents listen to this podcast. Yeah, okay. You know that, right? And you're talking about froth. You're talking about effing. You're talking about fleshlights, yeah, which I'm totally into, and I'd like to get a couple.
When
you are doing this all in front of Esther while she's wearing pajamas
with penguins on them and hearts and stars.
Penguins, and hearts,
I
and stars.
I wanted to talk about caramel apples.
Caramel apples.
There it is.
Available at Cantor Delis.
Caramel apples.
Cantor's Delis.
Cheddar bunnies and cinnamon crunchies.
Say cheddar bunnies.
And all those are cheddar on your bunnies wish list, so people say, can get them.
Say cheddar bunnies.
Cheddar bunnies.
Cheddar bunnies.
Cheddar bunnies.
Say it slow.
Cheddar bunnies.
Yeah. I'm getting pulled into Esther now.
Oh, a lot of guys have been.
What? Oh my God. Oh my God. No.
You just said your link doesn't work on the link up your Amazon wish list?
I don't know. You said it didn't work.
I didn't say it didn't work.
And I tried to get to it.
No, I just couldn't search for it. Yeah, oh, see, it's working.
What? Are you going to put up your photo?
Oh, my God. That's not my... That's
yeah,
not
this
my...
is you, little Esther.
Scroll down.
Black glass bunny tail butt
anal
plug.
Anal lube?
Clean stream water-based oh anal. Brian, you get that off there, okay? Brian, you get
you
that off there.
You cannot put anal lube next to cheddar bunny.
You don't do that. That is not cool.
Isn't this cute, though? You put it in your butt, and it looks like you have a little bunny tail. I think it would look adorable on Esther.
That is the dumbest, weirdest... No, I don't want to judge anyone, but I don't want that. Brody, yell at him. Brody, tell him. Brody, tell him. Why do you have access to making that? Brody, please. Take that off.
All right. That butt plug, I think, is cute. And I think you would look really good in it.
Well, I don't want it.
Are girls into butt plugs?
No, that's the new thing, actually.
What are you talking about? You're making that up.
No, it's not.
What does that even do?
Butt plugs have
I've
become...
I've seen butt plugs.
Yeah, more popular. Like the jewelry, the butt plug jewelry has become popular. I don't
Explain
know if you've seen...
Explain it to us.
All right. Butt plug jewelry is like this, where, you know, you fit it in and it's like has it. You could also get like cat tails or lion tails.
What is the point of that? Then you have to feel something up your butt.
But a lot of girls think it feels good. And like this is butt plug jewelry, where like one side is a butt plug, the other side is like a gem.
Yeah, don't knock it till you try it.
And it like looks better than a butthole. You know, like if you're walking around and you have some beautiful jewelry in your butt, that looks better than a butthole.
Who is going to see that?
People
with X-ray vision?
No. Like your boyfriend.
I like a gel pad.
And then these are like, you know, like you put this in your...
It's taking forever to load.
I know. It's just... I give up.
Do they have any male versions?
Yeah, you can use them. Anyone can use them.
Oh, they're unisex. Yeah, of course.
Yeah, everyone's butthole is the same, pretty much.
Yeah, 10%.
I mean, Esther's a little bigger than normal's, but...
Okay, that's disgusting and not true. I'm a mini person. I'll be right back. I have to go potty.
Because you're a mini person, does it mean your butthole's smaller than ours?
Brian, that's, again, a graphic statement.
No more!
Damn. Shake it. You think it's hot that when she wears pajamas like that?
It's interesting.
Yeah, it is, because it's like we're hanging out with a child.
It's a child.
Yeah, but she's got boobs.
I don't look at Esther that way.
You don't?
No.
When she comes back in, will you try to look at her that way?
No.
Just like try to look at her as if she's just like this.
I won't cross that line. Just like my psychologist. I won't cross that line.
Just do it for like a minute though.
No.
Not even for just studying it. Like, you know, for research.
I wouldn't do it. I'd be uncomfortable. But that's what I did with, you know, other things. I went there. I went up to the line, touched it, and came back. And I'm a better person for that.
The line? Oh, yeah. The 10% thing?
Yeah, I'm 10%. You know, everyone. And I'm cool with that. Guys give me a hard time, but
Has there been a lot of negative feedback about it?
No, but guys joke with me. People joke with me on Twitter. And I knew, like, when you drop a bombshell like that, that you're 10% gay, you know that there are going to be people out there who are going to send you hate tweets,
right,
or joke about it. And, you know, it's a sensitive subject.
Has anyone called you a faggot? Yeah.
I think you were the first. And that is a form of bullying. It's podcast bullying.
Wait, what happened? What was bull? Who?
I've been podcast bullied.
What happened, Brody? Tell me.
Brian asked, because I'm 10% gay, he asked, has anybody called me a faggot? And it just like struck a nerve with me. Is that the hate that's out there ready to be thrown in my direction?
I just asked if that's happened yet, because it seems like that would be something that somebody would do.
No, but I get the 10% gay hashtags a lot. But I had, you know, I feel better that I, you know, went public with it. And I have another bombshell to drop.
Mm-mm. What?
Which I'll drop later. I have two bombshells I'm going to drop.
Is it hangover related?
No.
What is it, Brody?
I can't.
Brody.
Give us a hint.
Yeah.
One has to do with, I think I have a learning disability.
Oh, that's.
I mean, I actually do have a learning disability.
Yeah.
I don't know how to type. I wasn't bar mitzvahed. I didn't go to prom. I took a special ed course in fourth grade. They put me in one of those courses.
I got held back in third grade.
You did?
Yeah. Gifted program, you losers. I'm just kidding. I'm sorry.
Esther, don't do that to me.
I'm sorry, but I meant it to Brian. I don't think that you have a learning disability.
I think I have a learning.
You didn't go to prom and you didn't get bar mitzvahed. Those do not.
I didn't get my driver's license until I was 18.
Same.
I should have had it earlier.
I got mine when I was 18 too.
Well, I feel like I've not accomplished normal man things in life. And because of that, I feel like that's one of my reasons that I feel that I struggle, because I haven't done those, you know, natural, you know, you go to prom, you go to fall formal, you go to church.
Yeah, that means anyone that's homeschooled is fucked, and that's not true.
They're fudged.
All right, maybe you're right. Maybe I'm just overdoing it. But
why do you always find that you have to dissect yourself? Instead of looking at the positive things, you're always looking, trying to find some of the negative things about yourself.
You know, Brian, that was one of the nicest things you've ever said to me.
Yeah, I like that a lot.
And I really appreciate where that's coming
from. What are some of the positive things, Brody?
Okay, some of the positive things. I have good shoulders. I have attractive eyes. I'm not a thief. I'm honest. I know how to drive a stick shift if necessary. I will hike Runyon Canyon with you. I am a good MC. I'm a good audience warm-up. I'm good on Chelsea Lately. I was good on my HBO pod. What did I do for HBO?
TV show.
I did a TV show for HBO on the internet. I'm good at podcasting. I'm a good son to my mother. I could be better. I feel like I could be a better son. But I'm doing what I can. I call every day. I feel like I can be a better brother, and I'm being that right now. That's one thing I feel like later in life, I become a better brother to my sister. And I want to become a better nephew to my uncle. My uncle just had quadruple bypass surgery, my dad's brother, Dick. I want to wish him a healthy recovery. You know, it's a Brody tradition, if you will, to have quadruple bypass surgery. My dad had two double bypasses. My mom had quadruple bypass. I had a hernia back in 2000.
What's a hernia? Is where you get like, my dog used to have a hernia and it had a big lump in his stomach where it was like a bone or something.
Yeah, I think there's a couple different kind of hernias. My hernia was down in my testicle area. I strained.
Oh, shit.
Like my left testicle was sensitive, and I would tap on it, and I could feel the pain go all the way up in my stomach. So the hernia is where, I guess you, I forget exactly, but it's like your stomach muscle down there, it's strained. Something got strained or tore. So they went in there laparoscopically, like through my belly button, and fixed it up and put a mesh screen in there. So I did have a hernia, yes, and I had it fixed. Like my testicle was just sore. I felt like something happened, but that's an indicator of a hernia.
When I was in high school, I had too many boogers all the time, and I had a sinus infection every 2 weeks, and I had to get a surgery where they drained my boogers out. It's not.
Oh, it's disgusting.
I have that one of those machines, the sinus machines, where
is it a RhinoFlow?
It's a neti pot, but it's an electronic one, and it just looks like a big vibrator almost with like this thing. You just plug it in one side of your nose, and it shoots like this salt water.
Yeah, I have that. I had to use that all throughout high school. It's called a RhinoFlow. Is that what you have?
Probably.
Does it work good?
Not many people have that. It's really embarrassing and dorky to talk about. But yeah, it shoots saline solution up your nose, and then like after a minute or after 2 minutes of it just doing that, then you are supposed to hold the other one and go and blow it all out into there.
Yeah,
it's really awesome, actually.
And it's really good if you have like allergy things, or here's what it's.
Could you do that with semen also?
What it looks like.
Oh, mine's different. Mine's,
I'm sorry,
like,
about that.
I had to get mine like.
I just keep pictures of it in my phone all the time.
Sorry that, but I said that.
Mine was ordered by a doctor. It's special for nerds. It's like a full machine.
Yeah, this is a full machine.
No.
But you can buy this one at CVS.
No.
But it's great for like if you have allergies and shit like that, because it like really clears out your sinuses. It clears out your nose. Like I know a lot of people have sinus problems right now.
Yeah, I had chronic sinusitis. So they had to go in, cut into my sinuses, and just drain it all out to get, because nothing else was working. And it ruined spring break freshman year of high school. I had to just, you know, lay low. Maybe that was the beginning of the end for me.
Nick Brady.
Are girls into butt plugs? Who put that up there?
Johnny.
That's funny. IKEA's bullshit. Epic, truly epic. We're getting good feedback. Are girls into butt plugs? Brody, butt plug jewelry is becoming more popular, like cattails.
Yeah.
Worries have been averted. You can't put anal lube next to cheddar bunnies. How dare you?
Brian, why isn't there any chocolate in the studio?
Because I'm not a girl.
Oh, but you like girls.
Yeah.
Brody, you like girls.
Yes, I do. In fact, I had a masturbation session this morning. I normally do it at night when I do it, but I haven't done it for about a week, and I just felt like...
A week?
What's going
what
on?
What the fuck, dude? You haven't masturbated in a week?
Can we talk about Carmel apples?
Yeah.
Damn. Well, that's not good, man.
Brian, don't judge
Wait, him. Brian's being serious here.
No, he's both. No, I'm being 100% serious.
Why is it not good?
Because that's way too much pressure in your
build up.
I masturbated 3 times today. Twice before I came here and once before you guys got here at the studio.
That's enough.
You jerked off in the studio here?
Yeah. That's enough, you guys.
Then look what's on my desk, like fucking lube right here.
Wait,
oh my God, we need to keep it positive.
Brian,
you
masturbate in the Death Squad studios.
Where did you come?
I cummed in my own hand, like a little magician hand thing.
Did you wash your hand with soap?
Yeah, I definitely washed my hands. Because,
with soap?
Because,
with soap?
Yes, because
confirm
this,
you use soap.
Yes, I did use soap.
I fist pound with Brian, so I'm not worried about it.
Yeah.
Unless it gets on your outer knuckles.
Well, it kind of got in between my fingers a little. But
I'm out of here.
It was sticky. This stuff is a little sticky, so I had to wash my hands.
Let's keep it clean, Brian.
So you masturbated only once this week.
It's been a while, yeah.
Did a lot come out? Was it like a like triple the amount? Or
yeah, I drenched the paper towel.
Wow.
I mean, I just exploded through that Bounty quicker picker upper.
Yeah.
I soiled it.
Yeah.
And it felt great. And it relieved some pressure.
Do you think maybe that it was a good reminder that you need to do it more? I mean, I really believe you need to do it at least twice a day.
I need to be doing it more, but I think part of that has to do, honestly, and I don't want to bring it up because, hey, don't bring it up. That's all you talk about.
It's okay, bro.
It could be the medication.
Oh, right.
It could be the medication.
Did you go online and look at a video? Did you go to My Free Cams?
No, I used my head.
No.
Who just burped like that?
That was Brian.
That was me.
That was not a little Esther burp. That was a big
I'm sorry.
Brian
that
burp.
Was actually a burp that I didn't know was
no, coming. I used my imagination of a sexual experience that I had with a girl.
With a unicorn.
With another girl.
What's going on with the girl from Irvine?
We have emailed each other a couple times. I might go meet her in Santa Monica, but I haven't followed up on it. I've been actually, to be honest, these are the two things that I'm focused on, if you want to be honest with
yes.
me. One is podcasting. Two is my comedy. Three is structure. Four
like the clothing store that's in Sears
no,
now?
No. Structure for my life, Brian. Not a store that's inside of a Sears.
Yeah, where they also happen to sell the Kardashian collection where I bought my Kim Kardashian designed jumpsuit. For $49.99.
Honestly, I'm not putting the energy out to be in a relationship or to be with women right now. I just don't think I'm putting that energy out. I'm putting out more towards like, hey, I need to get my career going. And I've had a good year. If you look at what I've done since I've cut back on my masturbating, I've actually had more TV credits. When I shot the HBO documentary that I did, with Brody Stevens Enjoy It, 6 15-minute episodes, I probably only masturbated 5 times through that whole shooting period. You know, it's like a boxer. You don't want to have sex because it makes your legs weak. I had very strong legs through the taping of the HBO project.
Is there a season 2?
Right now, officially, no. We've been in discussions.
Were they happy with the feedback or the response? Did the first one get a lot of good ratings? Was there a lot?
I don't know the ratings were, but it was critically acclaimed. If you want me to toot my own horn, it was.
I need you to toot it twice a day.
It was received in a positive light by many people. So I don't even know where we stand on HBO's radar. I mean, they basically agreed to do a season 2, but I think it's budgetary issues we're trying to get together with. And I'll have to wait for Zach to, come back in town and come back and, lay the hammer down. Zach Galifianakis, friend of Stephen Brody Stevens. You got it. We can't be stopped. So we'll see. Whatever happens, happens. Look, I'm not going to be in Hangover 3. That's a reality. It looks like that is not going to happen. There wasn't a part for me, and there's only, a couple more weeks of shooting.
Do you think maybe they're going to try something different, like maybe CGI you as a joke?
No. I would like to be in Hangover 3 just because I could say I've been a part of the trilogy, and of course, who doesn't want to be in another movie that's going to be watched by a lot of people? But it looks like right now I'm not going to be in Hangover 3.
Have you talked to Zach about it lately?
Yeah, I saw Zach the other day. He was in town. And he told me, he says, basically, he's been trying to get me in, saying, Brody would be good for this, Brody, 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 but there really hasn't been any part for me to play that would be up my alley, so to speak. So
you think maybe he's just teasing you about it?
I don't think so. I don't think I'm in the frame of. I don't think my close friends would tease me.
No, I mean right like now. Not tease you like that, but like tease you like a surprise. We got a role for you.
It's possible, but I doubt it. I think Zach is pretty straightforward and honest with me, and he would tell me that keep a lookout for a phone call or look for an email from production. That hasn't happened yet, and I'm totally cool with it. I'm totally cool if I never do another movie again. I've got Chelsea Lately coming up on the 29th of November.
You see that episode where she was naked in the shower with Sandra Bullock?
Uh-uh.
It was the first episode when they got to the new studio.
Really?
And it starts off with her and Sandra naked, completely naked.
Were they both naked, you think?
Yeah, you could tell. I mean, there's even one part where I think you could see Chelsea's nipple. It's on YouTube.
Oh,
it was actually pretty hot.
I'd like to see it.
Can we talk about one thing real quick? This is kind of gross, but going back to your story, because people were tweeting like, "I don't like it when cum gets on my hands." People are saying that they shoot their loads. Mine never really shoots. Once in a while, it would be like, "Wow, that's a surprise," but most of the time, it just kind of like just collects. It does. It just kind of goes down on the.
Well, I can still shoot.
Like, do you have to push harder, or do you like almost like you're peeing hard when it happens, or?
Well, I'll tell you what. When I was in Seattle, I used to have a towel, and somewhat so in New York, but I had a cum towel.
Right.
And I would lay it out on the floor, and I'd be on my knees, and I would be watching the pornography. And then when the guy would ejaculate, I would ejaculate with him as well, but I'd shoot it out all over my towel.
So you'd actually like lay the towel on the ground and try to aim for it almost.
Yeah.
Instead of like just putting the towel over it like a muffle, like you're kidnapping a girl.
No,
I'd
be on my knees.
Oh, I see.
I'd be on my knees masturbating.
And you'd shoot it straight down.
And no, not straight
down.
Why
on your knees? Is that hard on your knees?
They can get you can get some rug burns, but I'm saying like you put the towel out long.
Right.
So my knees are basically on the edge of the towel.
And you
right
just
there.
Constantly use the same towel, like anytime.
Yeah, for like a week or two, and
now,
then
like
wash
if you
it.
Unfolded it once, like it was a little wet still, and you got it on your hands.
No, I mean yeah, a little bit. I just wash my hands. But
in my experience,
go ahead. But I have hardwood floors now. So for me to get on my knees and masturbate, it's painful.
Yeah, that would
unless
be
it were like knee pads. But my new place, I have carpet. So part of my rehabilitation is to going back to masturbating with the towel out.
Yeah.
And like really watching it go far.
I would highly recommend using My Free Camps in the future. I think you're going to really, really fall in love with that website.
Is it free?
Yeah, it's free.
Will you explain it to us?
Yeah, can you explain it?
It's a cam website,
right?
And it's free. And it's just you go to look at hundreds of girls. You can even go by country. Like I usually go with Brazil and look at like the Brazilians. And then sometime I'll go into Asia and look at that. But like if I'm feeling really dirty, I'll go to Russian girls. There's even African girls, but they just have a bunch of cucumbers lined up and like these humongous vibrators that look like horse dicks. And it just creeps me out a little, but it's cool and it's free. And if you want to, you can like you know attach a credit card to it and buy tokens, which is like a way to tip them. So a lot of times,
oh, tokens.
Yeah, so it's like a lot of time you just throw them like you know like a dollar, you know, and they'll be like, oh, thanks. Here,
well, here. What are the girls doing?
Most of them are masturbating.
That doesn't do it for me.
A lot of them are having sex, like two girls.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, I can go for that.
Yeah, bunch of different stuff.
But what's wrong with just a good... I used to get free DVDs from Evil Angel and Vivid. From
Yoshi.
Not Vivid, but... Yoshi. Yeah, from Yoshi. I'd get a lot of DVDs. Mm-hmm. And then, obviously, like the internet, YouPorn made it easy to go on there and do it. But some of these DVDs, it's just clear. You're getting... Like, I feel like the stuff you see on the internet that's free, they're not good scenes.
Well, that's
okay. Yeah. I'm gonna have to.
Esther, this is guy talk right now. This is you know what?
Esther has porn on her phone.
Look, that was one time, and that was my BlackBerry.
Yeah, she had like 12 videos. When I first started dating her, I was going through her phone, and she's like, "Look, I have all this porn on here."
Okay.
Is that true?
I'm trying to turn a new leaf, keep it clean.
What are you, a gardener?
And to get the videos on a BlackBerry is no easy task. She went through a lot to get those videos on there.
Sometimes you're traveling and you don't have internet access and you want to watch porn, okay?
Where were you traveling? To the grocery store?
I can't remember. Oh, sometimes your internet's down in your apartment.
Need emergency porn.
Yes.
So you definitely masturbate a lot. How many times a day would you say you masturbate, Esther?
I'm not answering this.
Why can't you answer? We're adults here.
I don't masturbate every day. It depends what's going on in my life, how busy I am.
Usually before you go to bed or when you wake up in the morning?
I don't know.
Do you lay a towel out like I used to do?
No, I don't have like a residue that comes afterwards.
It sucks back in.
Do you visualize when you're doing
most of the time?
It?
Or do you do porn videos?
I watch videos.
Girl, girl? Guy, girl?
Anything.
Guy, guy? Do you ever watch any guy, guy videos like Brody?
Wait, Brian, stop that. You know what? I clicked and I went somewhere that I'm not proud of, but I did go there and I did look and I was interested by what was happening, but in no way do I want to do that. And I went to Bangkok and I figured that out.
I like a variety. You know, it's not like food where I eat something I like and then I eat the same thing every day. It's more, I'll see a homepage of a porn site and just say, hey, what's new? What's everyone looking at today? And I'll click on that, and I fast forward a lot. And if that's good, then I'll stick with it and make it happen.
You do, really? So, Brian, wait, somebody said that you went on Joe's show and said I was with a lady boy.
What?
Somebody said something.
Well, we were talking about the last podcast that we had. Because I said, remember that photo I showed you of that really hot lady boy last podcast?
Yeah, she was hot.
Yeah, and I go, Joe, would you fuck this girl? And he goes, who wouldn't? Of course I would. And I'm like, well, because it's a guy. Like,
oh, you trapped him.
I trapped him.
And what did he say?
And then he's like, what the fuck? And then I was like, oh, me and Brody, we had this podcast and we talked about all this. We talked about last episode.
Right. So what's the, if you do something with a lady boy, what does that make you?
Well, I think we figured it out that it doesn't, like, it just depends how you feel now about it. Like, if you're thinking about that lady boy every day.
No, I don't.
And you want to have more lady boys.
No, then, I don't.
Then you're not gay. You're just
European.
You're European.
They do stuff like that?
When in Rome, you know.
God, you're making me feel so much better about myself.
Brody, you should feel great. Brian, you should feel okay. Esther, you should feel less than nothing.
Why? Less than nothing, Esther?
Esther, should I show him a picture of my dick and see what his reaction is to it?
No. I'm not into that.
No.
I'm not into that. I'm not into seeing your penis, and I'm not into it.
Thank everyone for coming tonight.
Esther, we're not done yet.
Yeah, we are. It's been 2 hours. There's been so much talk about masturbation and dirty stuff, and we try not to do that, but today we really let it slip, and it's okay once in a while, but I don't want it to be known as the podcast that talks about frothy loads, so let's just clean it up. Let's end on a positive note of caramel apples or apple cider or whatever your traditional fall favorite treat is, and let's just carry on in the night. And daylight savings is getting darker earlier, so our emotions are high, things are stressful, it gets dark, we're like, where's the sun? And then you are reminded of your childhood, and you want to have your mom lay in bed with you so it's easier to fall asleep, but she says, no, you're too old for that, and it's a huge thing. So I think everyone should just have a good night.
That's a beautiful speech.
Thank you, Brody.
Can you repeat it? I want to transcribe it. I miss laying my head on my mom's stomach.
Me too. Well,
yeah. She was reading the Sunday paper. I can remember those moments. Her breathing.
How old were you?
Like 20.
What?
What?
Why would you be laying your head on your mom's stomach when you're 20? You didn't do that.
Just a...
Brian, you're in love
remember
with your own mom.
Remember my youth. Remember my childhood.
You're in love with your own mom, Brian.
No, I'm not.
We all want to go back to the womb. Yeah. And, but my mom would always like, she didn't like that. Like, you're nagging me. I nagged my mom a lot.
Same. That's exactly how it was. My mom's like, you're nagging me. Stop it. You don't need another hug. Stuff like that.
Yeah, my family are not like a bunch of huggers. I'm not a hugger. I'm a fist pounder. I wish my mom would fist pound me. You know, I would have been happy with a fist pound. You know, but we didn't hug a whole lot. And I need to make that change. I need to start hugging more.
Obama 2012.
Make that change. Hugging is a great thing. Some people are part of cuddle clubs.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah. What? You like to cuddle, right?
Yeah, it's just yeah, all you do is you just spoon with people.
With bugs.
You cuddle with bugs?
I don't know what I said.
You said that. And that's okay. You make mistakes and you learn from it.
Friendly bugs.
Are there any cockroaches in your apartment?
No.
I've seen a couple cockroaches in my apartment.
Uh-oh.
But I'm moving.
They lay eggs in your ears when you're asleep.
Stop.
I've got like a bite under my eye or something. I can't see it on the camera, but...
What's a cuddle club? I'll join.
No, I mean, people want to like just cuddle in a non-sexual way. You know, humans need touch.
Yeah.
So if you don't have a girlfriend or a boyfriend or something like that, you need to cuddle.
Have you done it?
Sometimes when
I've not signed up for them, but if there's a Groupon out there, I would look into it.
Sometimes when I feel the need to cuddle, I go to Chipotle.
Cuddle with a burrito bowl?
Yeah, or a burrito.
I'm so hungry.
I haven't gone to Chipotle for a while because it affects my stomach. I've been doing more Zanku chicken. I've been doing Subway.
I like Subway.
What do you get at Subway?
I change it up. Turkey, veggie.
You know what's depressing? Going to Subway on Thanksgiving and getting a 6-inch turkey.
Yeah.
On week.
Yeah, because you should get a foot long.
That's what's depressing about it?
Mine's been even worse because I just have lean pockets every Thanksgiving.
You do?
Yeah. Like last year, I spiced it up and got one of the pretzel bread ones.
Oh, I had that at your place once.
Yeah.
I think on Thanksgiving.
It was probably Thanksgiving.
Black Friday. Hot pocket.
I wish my mom would fist pound me more.
Fist you?
We don't judge, right? I like reading the comments from the on my Twitter while the show is going. I mean, now I'm more of a joke writer. I've gone from the master of hashtags to the master of the joke on Twitter, and I'm getting retweets. I mean, to have 37,000 followers and also have 250 retweets on a tweet that you put out, that's pressure. People are looking at me now. What's his next move going to be? What's he going to tweet next? What's he going to say? What joke is he going to write? This guy is a joke writer, and his name is Stephen Brody Stevens. Yes! Esther, I'm playing to the cameras. That's why it got quiet, because we were smiling on camera. You know, that's the one thing about this podcast. We do it live on Ustream. So a lot of times on the podcast, when you hear it later, when you hear it later, if there's a pause, know that Brody, Brian, and Esther were playing to the camera. Don't feel like...
What are you doing?
In the Midwest together. People
no, please don't play this.
And then please don't play this.
I like how you do that echo stuff.
Like there's like Esther.
Is that Comedy Union or West Side Eclectic?
Yeah.
Why did that let them put your shit up on stage? Did you want it on stage?
No.
Seems kind of weird. You look different here. You look older or something.
What?
Can you put it up? Can I hear what you say?
No, I'd rather not play it if that's okay.
God, you're demanding.
What?
Is that from your lawyer?
How am I demanding?
I'd rather you not play it. It's on the internet, Esther.
You think I look older?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, maybe it's because you're not wearing pajamas, but you're also wearing makeup there.
Your hair is long.
Yeah, your hair is longer.
How often you wash your hair?
Whenever it feels like it's totally necessary.
How often is that?
Like every couple days.
Oh, really? I thought it was going to be more on the lines of like a week.
Oh, no. I have a lot of hair, and it's really bad, and it's annoying.
You wash it in the sink, don't you?
In the bathtub. And I have to get a haircut, and I know my mom yells at me because I wash my hair in my dirty shaved leg water, and it's not clean, but I don't care. And yes, I need a haircut, and I'm thinking about getting one.
Your skin is great. How often are you washing your face?
As needed. Stop.
It's kind of trippy. Ooh. So, Brody, are you going to the Comedy Store tonight?
I am going to drop off these boxes at my new apartment. I need to do that. I can't have them in my car for 3 days and not drop them off. That's number one. Number two, I need to go back home and do possibly some more packing.
Enough is enough.
And then I need to get up in the morning. So I may not be at the Comedy Store is what I'm saying.
Stop, Brian.
Brian.
It's good having Don Barris back. He was back last...
Don's mad at me.
Or somewhere.
Dom Barris is mad.
Why is Dom Barris mad at you?
Because he said I bumped him on Saturday night.
He wasn't even in town.
He didn't get into town until he went straight from the airport on Saturday night, and he got at the he arrived at the Comedy Store around 12:30. And I was scheduled for the main room, but I had to cancel that spot because I got another paid gig. And I just wanted to switch it up. And I did the main gig, the new gig, and then I came back, and they basically offered me a spot in the original room. So Don thought I bumped him. That's all I'm saying. Don, and he's mad at me right now. Stop fighting. Did you just punch her?
He punched me.
Wait, that was real. I saw a fist. Brian, I can't accept that. I mean, the sex talk, that's one thing. But when you're getting physical and you're trying to punch.
I was just grabbing her boob.
I saw a fist, Brian.
No.
Esther, get on the mic so we can hear what happened.
I was reaching over.
I saw that.
And I was trying to get the iPad mini because
the iPad
I'm
mini.
Ready to look at some stuff. Stop it! Enough is enough. Stop. I can't.
Esther, stop laughing because you use your... Esther, talk into the microphone, please.
Serious? Brian, stop. Okay?
Esther, we can't hear you when you're not talking to the mic. Please talk into the microphone. This is Stephen Brody Stevens. What happened? Obviously, you're shaken up by it.
I was assaulted.
Yes.
And this is my testification. And I would like to see the iPad mini so that I could look at some snacks.
It's charging right now.
Well, I know that it is charging, but it's still usable.
God, you're getting aggressive.
She is aggressive. She's got a heavy flow, too, right now.
Brian,
that's
again,
inappropriate.
I mean...
You have no idea what's going on with me.
That's why you're...
Okay.
That kind of talk is not necessarily... If I hear that word again, I'm going to take a hit of marijuana.
Brody, no.
What? What word? Heavy flow?
No, how do I Brody, say, no. Say, Brody, no. Stop.
Yes. Positive push. Positive push.
This is a sensationalized podcast, and we're...
Yes.
Out of control. Wrap it up.
You got it. Hashtag friendship. Steven. Steven. Coming at you. That was cool, Brian. I could do that the whole show.
I know. We should just do a whole show in Echo.
How did you do it?
This great show. I want to say special thank you to P.F. Chang's and a shout out to Sears for
structure.
The Kardashian collection.
Keeping
thank you
structure
to Structure
alive. And Chess King.
Thank you to Olive Garden as
Chess
always.
King.
Thank you to Onnit.com and thank you to my parents for not pushing me to stay in school. All right, this has been great. You can find me on Twitter
at
Little Esther.
Esther, Instagram, why are you like taking over the show with the goodbye?
Instagram Esther Monster.
Can I say some stuff?
Of course, Brody, but you guys are just talking about frothy loads and you're not getting to the goodbyes.
Well, you started going into the goodbyes right away.
This is my second time trying to go into the goodbyes.
I was going
to
ask Brian one thing
about my
Twitter.
I was physically assaulted twice. I'm going to press charges, and this is my testification, and it's over.
That's cool, Brian. Yes. Can I give a plug or anything for what I got? Please tweet me at Brody is me friend. You can buy my t-shirts and stickers at brodymerch.com. You can email me at brody@brodystevens.com. B-R-O-D-Y at brodystevens.com. You can find me on Chelsea Lately this November 29th. I also have my own podcast, the Stephen Brody Stevens Festival of Friendship, but I am loyal to Death Squad, Ice House Chronicles, Brode and Esther. We got the shows going on here. Brody is me friend. Oh, yes, on Twitter. You got it. Esther, a neighbor. She will ill flaunt it. Going back to the Valley tonight. 818, and it feels so right. Got a new car. Traded in with my mom. Doesn't have GPS, but I can go wrong. Down the street. 134. Exit Laurel Canyon. Close the door. Ding, 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 ding. Digital underground. Freaks come out at night. Oh, yes, that's what I'm talking about. I'm the best joke writer on Twitter. If you don't retweet me, it will hit her in the face. That's what she does. Esther has been on New Girl. Yes, and a commercial for True Blood. Esther, there she goes. Brian doing shows in Seattle and San Francisco. That's what he does. Stephen Brody Stevens with the buzz. I hike the canyon. I go real hard. I have a candy bar. McDonald's. Went there last night. Got a burger, some fries, and I'll squeeze you tight. Yes! Positive push. Hashtag Brody in the bush. You got it. Feeling good in Pasadena. Home of the Rose Bowl parade and game. That it is. Stephen Brody Stevens has no kids, but he wants to get a girl pregnant tonight. Shake it out with the masturbation squeeze tight. Yes. Positive push. Let me check my Twitter. Brody is me friend.
So this week I'm going to actually be in Dayton, Ohio Thursday with Tom Segura and Aaron Kleber. And then Friday we're going to be in Cincinnati. And we have a coupon code. If you use Red Cross, you get 2-for-1 tickets, and 10% of the sales goes to hurricane support for the people.
Hurricane Katrina?
Yeah. And then Saturday we're in Columbus, Ohio, but all the tickets are at deathsquad.tv or brownpapertickets.com, and just search for Death Squad.
Stay safe out on the East Coast,
I officially,
my friends.
Have a Death Squad related wish list on Red Band's Twitter and mine soon. And I like snacks and baths.
Positive push. That's my name. Stephen Brody. I don't do cocaine. I do 5-hour energy shots. Oh, yes. Exercise. Well, I'm wearing Guess jeans, denim. Yes, they are. Got a crate. I'll put it in the bar and I'll stand up on it. Change the channel. Put the Dodger game in companel. Made up a word just like that. Stephen Brody Stevens, you can call me fat. Yes, I do. A rhyme for you. I went to Arizona State U. Yes, positive push, you got it. Hashtag, and I will flaunt it. From the valley, 8-1-8, and I'm going home, and it ain't too late. It's a one bedroom with carpet. I'll lay down my towel and do it. Watching porn into chicks. 10% gay, but it's got a nicks like a razor that you get at Target. There is Brian trying to hit Esther again. They're fighting. Stop it. Stop it. Hey, guys, stop it. And if there's a remedy, we don't need it. Yeah. Smoking pot, driving a car, off the canyon, go very far. I work real hard. I do that. Play the drums and a hell of a lot. Yes, I can make stuff up. I can write it down and put it in a cup. Brian, what are you doing? Positive push. Stephen Brody Stevens takes you to the house and we'll get it even. Esther! Brian, stop harassing Esther. This is going to go viral. Let me check my Twitter at replies. Yes. Stephen Brody Stevens. Positive push. I've said it 8 times. Brian is getting physical with Esther. Oh my, Esther, Brian.
Ow, ow.
I'm going to make a citizen's report.
My God, you broke your...
He broke the headphones. That is so rock and roll.
Ow.
Esther, stop crying. You look like the girl from The Ring.
That's what I get.
All right. I think this is the end of the podcast. It got violent here. Brian attacked Esther and broke headphones. Headphones are broken. There's damage done in the studio. And then Esther threw down the headphones in anger. This is out of control. If this podcast doesn't go viral, I don't know what will. This is like the Hindenburg crashing. This will be video that will be ingrained in your memory for years and years to come. This is Stephen Brody Stevens signing off for Brody and Esther. We did it again. Hopefully we'll be back next week. Check us out.
Death Squad for life. Don't you dare. Don't you dare cross me. You got it. Moving into a new apartment. Boxes ready to be shifted. Blood starts coming out my nose.